Within 6 weeks, it was number one.
In a sort of pop type scene, because then I was married to John Mayall, who's a blues musician. Just a sweet little thing. Really naive and smart and intelligent and articulate then, I mean. Yeah.
It was a very good time, that first period for me. I was really delighted with myself and my confidence was high. Everything looked very beautiful. And I had some wonderful experiences. And this was before I took any drugs or anything, so they were completely natural. That this was the one of the best times of my life. And I really loved it. Young and rich, you know.
Just before her first big US tour, Marianne found out that she was pregnant and she and John were married. All she wanted was a conventional family life.
She was trying to be a mother, the baby with her, but at the same time doing two sets a night and being applauded, and it was very difficult then to come back and be a little housewife. It was very difficult.
It was completely doomed, all this period of domesticity. I wanted a sort of straight bourgeois marriage, you know, and I'd certainly picked the wrong person for that.
Got pretty unpleasant. I mean, she kind of got very weird about money at one point. It was just, she was seemed to just nag and nag about money. And yet, it was partly, as I think, her self-defence, because she was just going out without telling me and, like, buying mad clothes and not daring to bring them home. Because she's never going to wear them. It was like a kind of, you know, before she discovered heroin, that was her thing, was shopping.
I think Nicholas was about a year old, or a bit older, and I just had enough. I just couldn't go on.
It just didn't work, and it wouldn't have worked.
Yes, I'll be as true can be.
Months and months and months, I ignored Mick completely. And not realising, because I didn't know anything about sort of seduction technique, that this was in fact the dead sure way to make sure that he would hassle me more and more.
I'm in no hurry, I can take my time over.
Both very curious. Here were two separate, really fascinating worlds. There was the rock blues world with all its wonderful dark mythology, and the world that Marianne came from, an aristocratic, educated world that the Stones aspired to. And, you know, Mick is a very intelligent, funny, charming guy.
I mean, I know why I fell in love with him, because he was great.
And I'll forsake all of my life. Yes, I'll be as true can be. If you'll come and stay with me.
I left everything for Mick. Stopped working. Completely gave all my intelligence and my sort of innate grasp of the whole thing to him, to his music, to his work. I went too far, of course, as usual.
Well, she was playing really two roles then. She was being the glamorous star and the gorgeous girl on Mick's arm. And at the same time, I think her inner self was, like, sinking.
Because then it was the girls, like, when the boys were busy, the girls were kind of together. We didn't know what to do with ourselves. Like, when we were not really allowed into the recording studio, so it was, like, a bit kind of a macho male kind of thing. So we were just by ourselves.
They even had a clubhouse at the end of the garden where they would go and play and leave the girls to go shopping and, you know, find out what the next drug is, darling, you know.
The Stones were just beginning to get really powerful. And I was continually sort of shooting my mouth off about how wonderful it was to take LSD.
But something like LSD, if it wasn't meant to happen, it wouldn't have been invented. Because the really explicit phrase is doors of perception. And that is what drugs are. They are the doors. They're not anywhere. I mean, you don't go anywhere. You just see a crack like I'm looking at you now.
And it was all very uncool. I was real trouble like that, full of the joys of being young and strong.
I think I'm really powerful. They'll smash me, probably, but I want to try.
I had no idea what they could do, certainly to the point where all this stuff could be planned. And it was, in fact, we found out afterwards.
The effect of the encounter with the Stones would have been very different if it hadn't been for the bust at Redlands in February of 1967.
It was meant to be a lovely weekend taking acid with my dearest friends, which in fact it was, until 24 cops walked in.
There was Marianne coming from a day outside, had taken a bath, and went upstairs and wrapped this fur rug around her. So when the constable, the lady constable, I forget what her name was, arrived, I mean, she was horrified. You know, here is this bunch of poncy yobs in all this outrageous clothing, and obviously sort of like thuggish lower-class guys, and here's this sacrificial virgin, a sort of unicorn child woman that's obviously being sort of drugged and raped by these guys.
I mean, the Mars bar, by the way, is total fiction.
She was supposed to be sticking it up her fanny, I think.
That was thrown in by some journalist because we were right out of Mars bars.
Two of the Rolling Stones, Keith Richards and Mick Jagger, are waiting to be taken probably to Lewis prison.
Mick and Keith came out with an enhanced bad boy varnish. I came out of it diminished, demeaned, trampled in the mud. My feminine self had been completely besmirched by this.
What it did to Marianne was it totally changed her image. She was referred to in the press as Miss X. Nude girl, Miss X, wrapped in a fur rug. It made her into this person she really wasn't.
I'd accepted my role as bad girl in fur rug. I thought, right, you've cast me like this, I'm going to go for it. To hell with you all.
Falling from grace, falling from grace. Love, you have a pretty face. Take it away and pack it in a suitcase. Then forget about falling from grace.
I took the drugs because we were all taking the drugs and they were around. And whenever you're young and rich and successful and very powerful, there will always be creepy people coming along to give you drugs. You know, it's one of the things that you don't realise when you're in that position. And before you can think twice, you're in trouble.
Here I lie.